So, Chris, if someone wants to learn more about education reform, of course, they could watch Reform School every day.
Right.
That would be one thing, right?
For current events. Yeah. But if you're new to the ed reform movement and you want some background info on the history of education reform or on current public policy, there are some other institutes who are currently doing things to help creating classes and courses to help people get informed.
They say knowing is half the battle. And now, with the help of some ed reform organizations, it's less of an uphill battle. Choice Media is following multiple initiatives to spread awareness, including the Ed Reform University project in the works at Center for Education Reform, aiming to be an in-depth history lesson for reformers. President Kara Kerwin brought some of this to our attention.
As we were trying to go green, as we were trying to figure out the next way that we could help the newcomers, the new people, the new potential pioneers in the ed reform space, we knew that there needed to be sort of a depository of all that information of the past so that we can learn from it. But we have some modules for actual coursework, and the hope is that we can help groups, you know, for example, Bob Bowden brings on another Choice Media expert. How do we get them up to speed on these issues?
Another initiative is being set up by the groups 50 Can and the Fordham Institute. Choice Media spoke to 50 Can president Mark Porter McGee about Ed Reform 101.
There's a lot of people who are involved now in this movement to try to improve the way our education system works. And so much of that is grounded in what the research tells us. What are the smart policy ideas? And so we've kind of been out there. 50 Can is, you know, working to support local leaders running advocacy campaigns in different states. One of our biggest requests is, how can you help connect me to the experts in these different fields? And the basic idea is, we are bringing together some of the best professors and best experts in the country and giving you an opportunity to hear from them, read the essentials that they've put together on different topics, and actually interact with them in a virtual classroom.
And so this promoted, by the way, on the, well, we can cut to the website right now, Alex, and show you the Fordham Institute about this promotion for the second course you just heard about, Ed Reform 101, an online course on education reform. It looks like it's starting on September 12th, going to November 14th, and each week there's going to be, you know, readings, et cetera, and videos to watch and all this, 1 hour webinar, all, et cetera. So this is, I'm not sure I've ever heard of this before. Is it new?
I'm pretty sure it is.
Yeah, I'm not sure it's ever been done. And Catherine, this sounds like a good idea. You think so?
It does sound like a great idea, and particularly because of the focus there on the history of the school system in America and education reform. I think that it is really important when those of us on the side of greater parental freedom in education, we need to understand where a lot of these arguments have come from and what it is that people really think about the public school system, where those ideas came from. The public school system can be a very people have an emotional attachment to it based on our history and the way people grew up, and change can be difficult and seeing things in different ways. So I think it is very important to understand where we came from and the philosophy particularly behind the creation of the monolithic public school system that we have today.
Yeah, you know, my only problem with it is completely redundant with all the education schools at universities across the country. That's sarcasm, folks. They actually don't cover this. Apart from University of Arkansas, and there are a few universities that actually cover education reform, you know, by and large, we, on a regular basis, and Allison's over there who calls these people all the time, will talk to schools of education about the work we do and the kind of program we do. And it's fair to say there are some people who do step up, but the majority of them consider this stuff like, I don't know the right word to use, but it's not on their radar. Education reform to them is some sort of peripheral distraction that should be ignored by a bunch of crazy lunatics who are on a fringe, who are extremist wackos. It's pretty much often the reaction we get from schools of education. And so you would think, wouldn't you think, if you were running a school of education, this would be part of the, you know, especially if you have a 4-year curriculum for college students and you're teaching them all about the world of education, you'd include some school choice material and reform-minded stuff. It doesn't seem to be the case.
Well,
how about in Oregon? Like the big teacher colleges in Oregon, do they talk much about charter schools and tenure reform? And
I would say not.
Right.
there's a from my memory of being a college student, the thinking among students studying to be teachers was pretty much that they were very proud to be going into the system as it is today. I'm sure they had very good intentions about teaching kids and everything, but sure, it was not exactly a hotbed of change thinking.
Of thinking outside the box. Change thinking,
right.
Exactly, yes. Well, ladies and gentlemen, she is Catherine Hickok with the Cascade Policy Institute, and we appreciate your time on this Friday. Of course, it's earlier in Oregon right now than it is where we are here in New Jersey. And so you might start your weekend early. I don't know. Like, once you're done with this. Catherine, thank you very much.
Thanks so much, Bob.
All right. And for Chris, but not Heather, she's not here. Kate is also gone. But also we have a
New York
river.
City.
We got New York City, the river. And we have a song right now. What's the song we're hearing, Alex? We're in the Tonight Show theme song right now. My name is Bob Bowden. Happy Friday, everyone. We'll see you next time.